My name is Jelena, and I was diagnosed with colorectal cancer at age 34. This March, for Colorectal Cancer Awareness Month, I'm sharing my journal writings from the early days of my diagnosis to share with you what it's like to receive a cancer diagnosis. This is the second video in the series, so let me catch you up really quick and jog your memory on what happened in the last video. So I found out that the cancer had spread to lymph nodes, so I was considered stage 3. I told my 5-year-old daughter that I had cancer, and we had met with my oncologist and had gotten some potential treatment plans laid out for us, but it wasn't concrete because all of the test results hadn't been received yet. Now let's get back to my story. June 7th. Since I didn't hear from Dr. M yesterday, I called his office first thing this morning to see if he had heard from Dr. H and had the results from my EUS. I had to leave a message as today he is doing rounds at the hospitals. I took Mayel to her group tennis lesson at 9 a.m., then went down the hill to the park and met S with her kiddos there to play. While we were there, Dr. M called. He confirmed that the tumor is T3 and that I'll get started with radiation and chemo soon. He asked when I was scheduled to see the radiation oncologist, and I said it wasn't until June 17th. He said he'd make a call to see if he could fit me in sooner, and also was going to put in the order for my chemo pills so that they'd be here whenever I begin radiation. While we were in the middle of eating lunch, the radiation oncologist's office called to see if I could make it in today at 2 p.m. It was already 1 p.m., but I said okay and knew we could make it work. I made a quick call to S to see if we could take Mayel over to her place during the appointment. Then we went to pick up John from work, dropped Mayel off at S's, and made our way over to the hospital. We ended up being there for over 2 hours. I had paperwork to fill out. Then they took my vitals, then the radiation oncologist, Dr. P, came in to talk to us. He checked my breathing, felt around on my shoulders, head and neck, checking the lymph nodes maybe? Then wanted to do a physical exam of my rectum to feel exactly where the tumor was and the size so that he knew he was working off of correct information. He said that the EUS measured the tumor spanning from 4.5 centimeters to 15 centimeters in the rectum. So that's a distance of 4 inches. I have a ruler here, 0 to 4 inches. That's a pretty large size tumor. At least to me, that seems pretty large. I'm still really hoping that it will shrink away from the anus so that I can still pass bowel movements on my own when this is all over with. He then had us come back to his office to talk about side effects, to look at the CT scans, and tell us that this is a straightforward cancer that has very standard treatments. He also said that if he thought that I could get better treatment elsewhere, he would have no reservations recommending somewhere else, as he has many oncologist friends all over the country. But he said that they are perfectly capable of successfully treating this here in town, which was comforting to hear. He explained what would be happening over the next few days and ordered me to get an MRI, which he said would be useful to the surgeon to see a better picture of where everything is down there. He mentioned that studies have shown that there isn't a difference in survival rates in using the chemo pill versus chemo via an IV for this type of cancer, so they will prescribe the pill for these cases. So tomorrow, I go back to the office for a mapping CT scan to determine where exactly in my body needs treated. Based on the CT scan, Dr. P will map out where the radiation needs to be focused, which takes 2 to 3 days. Once that is complete, I will come in for a VSIM, a virtual simulation, of radiation to make sure that everything is lined up correctly before the actual radiation begins. Then, the following day, radiation would begin. Eek! This is all moving so fast! I'm kind of glad, though, that it's moving fast because I can't imagine waiting weeks for all of these tests and doctor visits to happen before treatment. Tuesday evenings are running nights with the group, so I was planning on telling them at dinner after our run. I had mentioned in the group text earlier in the day that I had something I needed to discuss with the group at dinner, so S, a different S, asked in an individual text if it had something to do with my doctor visits. I said yes, and that I'd tell her more this evening. Well, it ended up storming pretty bad, and no one wanted to meet to run outside. S texted me and asked if I wanted to see if people wanted to just meet up for dinner. She said no one must have noticed that I said I needed to discuss something, but it was up to me if I wanted to initiate dinner. So I did, and the core group of 6 of us all met up for dinner at 7. Once our orders were taken, everyone wanted to know what the news was. B wanted to try and guess, But I shut him down and said, nah, let me just tell you. So I broke the news to everyone, and they were all shocked. I filled them in on the major details and that treatment would be starting next week. They were glad that it could be cured, but said that it sucked. B and P offered to watch my L anytime we needed her not to be at an appointment. B offered to order food and bring it to us, since he doesn't really cook. S offered to help with rides if I ever needed one to any appointments. I thanked everyone for the offers and their support and said that I wouldn't be able to run next week because of the PET scan on Wednesday, and I'm not supposed to do any vigorous exercise for 24 hours prior to the scan, but that I'll try to be there every Tuesday still for our runs. They all said that if I need to go slower or stop for walking breaks, that's no problem, and they wished me well and to keep them posted on how things are going. Once I got home, John and I discussed how we want to handle the offers of my parents and his mom coming out to help. My parents said they don't care if they fly out now, then have to fly over to North Carolina for Janelle's wedding. They said to just take care of myself and do what we think will be best. So we decided to have them come out first and let them decide between now and over the next few days as to when exactly they want to arrive. Then after we get back from Janelle's wedding, we'll have his mom and maybe his dad come out for a week or two, then decide from there if we need help again from my parents or if we're good with help from friends locally. Right now, my biggest supporter, closest mom friend, and person that's most available and willing to watch my L is H, but they're out of town visiting family until the 24th, so I can't rely on them at all until then. June 8th. This morning I went in for my mapping CT scan at the Cancer Center, which is where Dr. P's office is located. They had me start on my hands and knees on the CT scan table, laid a towel over my butt, then had me pull my pants and underwear halfway down my thighs, then lay down on the table face down. There's a positioner to put my face on so I can breathe, and I have to put my arms around it like I'm hugging it to keep my arms out of the way. They put dots on the sides of my upper thigh slash butt, and right at the top of my butt crack. Then they had to tape a small wire on my crack too for a point of reference on the scan. Then the table rolled into the scanner, and I laid there for a minute or two while they scanned me. Once the scan was done, they turned the dots into plus marks and put circular pieces of tape over them so that if they were in the right spots, they would still be there for turning them into permanent spots when I go back in. Yep, I get to get 3 freckle-sized tattoos so they know where to position me each time I go in for radiation. They also said that when I go in for the actual treatments, they'll tape my butt cheeks apart so I don't get radiation building up in the folds of the skin there. Awesome. After I was done, they walked me down to another office to talk with a social worker before I left. The woman I spoke to said she's just there Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. She said that I could make an appointment in the future to meet with her, or just drop in, and if she's free, she'd meet with me, John, or any of my caregivers. She did say if we thought Mayel needed to talk to someone, that she'd have to refer us to someone that deals regularly with therapy for children. I talked to her a little bit about the scariness of getting the diagnosis, but not knowing how serious it was. Then the relief of hearing it's curable, and now the nervousness of treatment about to happen. She then sent me via email a 25-minute video of what exactly radiation therapy is, what to expect during the treatment, and the various side effects. John and I watched it together later in the evening, and I forwarded it to my parents for them to watch also. It was informative on what exactly happens and went over lots of side effects, which we've heard many times, but I'm sure could be helpful for my parents to hear. On my way out from the CT scan, I ran into Dr. M in the hallway. He immediately recognized me and began asking me if I'd heard anything yet about the chemo pills he ordered. I told him I hadn't, and he said that if I didn't hear anything by Friday, to give his office a call to follow up and see what's going on. I was surprised that after only meeting him once, that he recognized me and remembered everything about my case. I guess, though, I'm probably quite a bit different from most of his patients, at least in age, which makes me more memorable. Then on the drive home, I called A to tell her the news. She was bummed, but didn't sound too devastated. She just moved last Friday, so she's tired and stressed out from moving with a 7-month-old boy. During Mayel's nap, I called Jay to let her know, and she kind of reacted like Janelle did, with a long, deep sigh, followed up with a, that sucks. She offered to send us meals or remotely get us set up with a housekeeper if we needed either of those. I thanked her for the offer and told her I'd let her know if we needed either. I got a call this afternoon, too, to schedule our chemo class with the physician assistant in Dr. M's office. So we're going to that next Tuesday at 3:30 p.m. They recommend all caregivers come to that, so I made sure to let my parents know that when buying their plane tickets, they need to be here in time for that appointment. This afternoon, after my L's nap, we went to the gym, and I did well again for my 30-minute run. But the last 5 to 10 minutes of the run are starting to get difficult because I'm getting gas building up and start getting gas pains. I can't let out the gas while I'm running because most of the time when I do let out gas, fishy-smelling blood comes out with it too. I don't want that hanging out in my underwear while I run. I need to try to remember to get back to regularly taking gas X pills to see if that helps at all. We Skyped with my parents and Aunt G when we got back home, and Mayel had them cracking up and wowed at all she was doing, from showing off her Lego creations of Star Wars stormtroopers and the Death Star using just regular blocks, to her little doghouse she created out of pillows, a coffee table, and some drawings. Aunt G was amazed at how much energy Mayel has and said she knew now how I was so skinny. A little later in the evening, I got a text from my dad saying they got their tickets and they're arriving at 8:43 p.m. on Sunday. I'm excited for them to come out. It just sucks that it has to be under these circumstances. June 9th. Since everything is rolling along smoothly and my treatment is going to be starting next week, I could cancel my follow-up meeting with the doctor that did my colonoscopy, which was scheduled for next Wednesday afternoon. I also got to cancel tomorrow's MRI, because initially they told me I could go to the imaging place where I got my initial CT scan done, but Dr. P wants it done at a specific imaging place, because their MRIs have better detail. By the time I heard from that office, they couldn't fit me in until June 21st. We'll see if I get a call tomorrow from them trying to squeeze me in earlier, once Dr. P's office hears of the date that I'm scheduled for. Mayel and I sat down and watched the beginning of the radiation therapy video. She got to see what the machine looked like and a nice animated graphic of normal cells dividing and dying versus cancer cells dividing and not dying. She started to get bored about halfway through, so we stopped, but she got to see the important parts that I thought would be the most informative for her. I got a call this morning from Dr. P's office asking if I had received my chemo pills yet, and I mentioned that Dr. M was having the nurse J in his office take care of it, but that if I hadn't heard anything by Friday, that I should call them back. The woman knew that Jay wasn't in today, and she said she'd call the other nurse to see if the prescription had been sent off. Within 5 minutes, I got a call from the pharmacy up in Denver for them to go over how to take the chemo, common side effects, and to verify the address of where to send it and how soon I needed them. I'm impressed with how fast these offices work and the pull that they have. So I paid over the phone for the pills, $210 or so for the 1 month supply. And he said he'd have them overnighted via FedEx so that I'd have them tomorrow and would be ready whenever the radiation guys were ready. Sure enough, this afternoon Dr. P's office called again to say the radiation plan was ready and that they want to squeeze me in tomorrow at 2:15 p.m. for the dry run, then to meet with a nurse for patient teaching on the radiation therapy. They'll get me set up for my radiation time tomorrow and then I'll get started on Monday. When I heard that, I was really glad that my parents will be arriving on Sunday night. This evening, I finally got a hold of the last of my college roommates to tell her the news. She has a friend that just finished treatment for colon cancer, and she said that her friend had minimal side effects that mostly popped up near the end of her treatment. She said that the worst part was the sunburn feeling from the area that is being zapped by the radiation. She said that she'd ask her friend what lotions or creams that she used that were best to deal with the irritation, then let me know what they were. If they happen to be ones that are only available in Arizona, she said she'd ship some over to me. She also offered to come out if I needed help, or to just be available to talk if I needed someone to talk to. I'm so glad that I've finally told everybody that I need to, either in person or over the phone. I'll probably put up a post on Monday on Facebook for my first day of radiation to notify the rest of the people that I know. There's still a lot more story to share, so make sure you're subscribed so you'll get notifications when I post the next videos. If you liked this video, please hit the like button below and consider sharing it with your friends to help increase awareness for this disease. Thank you for watching.